Okay, so it's now time to create a real application. I guess in the previous section, it was a real application, our simple Hello World program, but we're now going to do a little bit more. We're going to create an application that actually does something constructive. It actually responds to a button click on the screen. So to start work, what we need to do is create a new Android Studio project. So I'm going to click on Start a New Android Studio Project, and I'm going to call this one Button Click Counter. We're going to leave the company domain as it was. Whatever you selected in the Hello World is fine. And you notice that the location for me, I'm saving it to my desktop in a subfolder called Android Programs. But you can obviously change that location to whatever is appropriate for your computer and operating system. Clicking on Next. And likewise, as I explained in the Hello World application, we're going to start with a minimum API 16, which means that we'll support any version of Android API 16 and higher. We're going to leave all these other options for Google Wear, Google TV, Android Auto, and Glass. We're going to leave all those off because we're only working with applications for a phone and tablet. Click on Next. We're going to select Blank Activity as I did in the previous application. Click on Next. And finally, we're going to leave all these options as the default, but we will discuss those a little bit more in this project so they start to make sense. Lastly, I'm going to click on Finish, and that's going to create this new project, and then we can get to work. So this work, it's working away. It's now set it up. So what I'm going to do is just go into full screen mode so we can see things a bit better by entering presentation mode, like so. And by the way, if you see these little green messages down the bottom of the screen, that is going to be showing you the corresponding shortcut to keystrokes that I'm actually using. There's actually a little plugin called Presentation Assistance that I've installed in my Android Studio. So that will actually signify any keyboard shortcuts I'm using. And even if I'm just using a menu option, it will actually show you what the equivalent option is as a keystroke shortcut. So it's a great way to learn various keystrokes. So if you see that and wondering what it is, that's what it is. Okay, now my screen has opened a little bit funny in that there's no project window on the left-hand side. So first things first, I want to show you how to get back to that mode if you need to. So there's two ways to do it. Firstly, we can just come up here and click on the menu, click on the View menu in Android Studio, go to Tools, Windows, and click on Project. Once we do that, we get our project, our familiar project here showing up on the left-hand side. That can be good to leave open while you're actually navigating through and selecting what to edit and those types of things and where you want to see the structure of your Android application. But it can also be good to turn off temporarily to make more room for other things. And a shortcut for that on the Mac is I can press Command and 1, and that will turn it off. And down the bottom it says Project via Command 1. But then I can come up here to the View menu, Tool Windows, and this will give you the corresponding keyboard shortcut to turn that on or off for your operating system. So that will be one that you'll probably turn on and off fairly often. Another one will probably be structure, and we'll show you, well, I'll show you that a little bit later on. So I'm going to put that back on for the moment because we actually need it. So first things first, we're going to just come up here where it's got Android and change it to Project, because generally speaking, going into Project View just gives you a better way to get access to the various elements within an Android project. So it's good to actually have that selected. But the other thing I also want to show you is you can actually open up multiple projects at once. So I'm going to go back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and open up another project. I'm going to go up to Open Recent. And our recent was Hello World, which was our previous application. So if I go to click on and open that, you come up with a little option, as you can see on the top of the screen. It's actually asking, do you want to open it and replace the project in the existing window? In effect, what that means is closing down the project, the current one, and opening a new one, or would you like to open it in a new window? So if I open it in a new window like so, then what actually happens is I've got two projects opened, and ignore that little error to the left hand, to the top right hand corner there. I'm not sure what was going on there. That was just an error that was coming up with Android Studio, but we'll ignore that. So we've now got two projects. If I just go back into project view again, we can see that it's the Hello World project that we created. And then I can actually then go up into window, and I can select either one of those projects. So I can have multiple projects open, and it will open the relevant one by going to the Windows menu and selecting that. And when I want to close one down, I can just come up here to File, Close Project, and that will just leave the one project open, which is the button click one in this case. So it's up to you as to whether you want to do it, but I just wanted to point that out, that when in doubt, come up here to the Windows menu and just see whether you've got any other projects open. It can be a good idea to close them. The other thing is, depending on the amount of resources you've got in your computer, how much RAM, how fast the CPU is, you may only want to have one project open at a time. So in this case, I'm going to leave just the one project open, but I did want to show you how to actually do that if you needed to. So next, we'll go back into some code. So with making sure that project was selected, we're going to expand out our code. So I've opened up the button click counter. And I'm going to click on app, click on SRC, and I'm clicking on the little triangle to the left-hand side, and then click on main, and then finally click on Java. Now this is where all the Java source files are. You can navigate to them in there. And you'll notice this first bit here is the package name. And if you recall, when we created this project, it asked for the package name, com.timberchowker, and then it's appended, as I mentioned in the Hello World app, button click counter to the end of that. And to get into main activity, we can just double click on that, and that will actually show the code now on the screen. So what we want to do is we want to add a simple action. So first things first, what we're going to do is we're going to actually run this application to see how it works at the moment, and then we're going to add a simple little bit of code to actually demonstrate the menu option working. So to do that, I'm going to click up into here and click on run, or select run I should say, and click run app. I could have actually done a command R here on my Mac to do the same thing. Now I wanted to show you what happens is if you haven't got an emulator already opened, or you haven't got a physical device attached, what will happen is it'll come up and actually ask you what you want to do. Now, if you remember in the last video, I actually had an emulator running, and I was able to choose a running device. But in this case, I haven't actually got anything running. But what Android Studio will do is allow you to launch it. So you could select from if you had multiple emulators defined, you could do that if you wanted to. And obviously, if you had a device running, it would show you that in that list. So in this case, I'm going to click on Launch Emulator and click OK. So that will actually start the emulator, and we'll leave it on the screen until it starts up. And then we'll just see the application running. Actually, what I'll do while that's running, I did want to show you something else. So we'll go back to Android Studio. I wanted to show you how this screen automatically opened up, and you can see that it's come up with some options here. And this has got to do with the emulator and that click back automatically by itself. So that's now running. So we'll wait till Android boots up, and then we'll go back and just see what's happened in Android Studio. The bottom line is that Android Studio has opened up some other windows, and it's going to be able to give you some information that's coming back from the Android application, or the Android emulator, I should say, and showing you that on screen. So at the moment, it's just booting up, and we need to wait until we can see that it's booted up, and then our application should automatically start because we selected that in Android Studio. And you can see it did auto-start, which is good. And again, we've nothing new there. We've seen that before. But the part that I want to show you is this little part here. We click on into that. We've got little settings, and if I click on settings, nothing happens. We've got nothing on the screen at this stage to indicate that anything's happening, but we're going to change that. We're going to go back to our code and actually add something to that. So I'm going to go back to Android Studio. Now I wanted to show you all this stuff here. Now this is all the information that's coming back from the Android emulator. Now a lot of this will look and probably not make a lot of sense to you, but we can actually use this, and you'll see this in use in future applications where we actually go through and actually look for certain bits of information from the log, because that's what this is. This is called Logcat, which is a way for you to find out what's happening on that device. And it can be useful just to click on some of these buttons just to go through and have a look. For example, the amount of memory that's been allocated on the Android device at this stage. Also the CPU resource, how much is being used, which can be quite useful. And you can see there was a big spike there probably when the application started. And now it's just using a little bit every now and again. The other thing I wanted to point out though is this is our application running here, com.timberchowker.buttonclickcounter. But if I click on that, we've actually got all these other applications, because what actually happens is all these things are actually running on this Android emulator. Because the emulator acts like a real Android device and is a real Android device in the sense that it's running the actual Android code that a regular Android device, a tablet or a phone would run, we've got all these other programs that are running. So you can actually monitor those too if you wanted to for some reason and see what they were doing. But usually you'll just select just your program, and you'll only want to see the information that pertains to that or relates to that. So that's that option anyway on the screen. And notice that this is called the Android screen, the Android window. And that's another one that you can get rid of if you want to. It can become a bit of a nuisance if you want to get into your code and this is sort of taking up too much of the screen. You can go up to the menu, view, tools, windows, and click on Android, or note the shortcut there. For me, it's command 6. If I can do that, I need to do it twice sometimes. So control 6, command 6, as you can see there. And I could do a command 1 if I wanted to actually turn that off, and so I've just got my code. So you can leave those on if you want to, and I'll put them back on again just to show the difference. But it can be, you know, really useful to get used to the keyboard shortcuts for those, because it will save you a heck of a lot of time and makes good use of your limited screen real estate to actually pop up on the screen what you actually want to see happening. All right, so let's actually get something happening and working on the screen now. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a simple toast message. And what toast is a mechanism that enables you to print messages on the screen. And what we're going to be doing, and I'll be talking more about this in the next video, we're going to be responding to an event. But we'll leave the concepts of what that all means to the next video. For now, let's just put in the code. So I'm going to type in toast. Now, it's very important when you're typing in Java code to enter the same case. So toast like that is not the same as toast like this. So you actually get an error in red there, which is Android Studio saying, I don't know what you mean. So make sure that you actually type things in the right case that you see me typing them in, because it does actually make a big difference. And that is a cause of a lot of errors for people just starting out with Android. I'm going to type Android toast message equals toast dot make text. And I'm going to type this and the settings menu option got tapped. And I'm going to type toast.length long. So what that line of text actually means is that we want to display something on the screen. In order to fix that typo up, we want to display a little message on the screen, and we're using this thing called length long, which is just an indicator to say show it for a longer period of time than you normally would. And then that's setting it up to show, but to actually show the message, we're going to type toast message dot show, like so. So what's going to happen is when the settings button is the menu button is tapped, the three little dots that you saw running in the emulator, we're going to show that menu on the screen. So let's run that. I can right click that and click on run main activity. And this time you notice it's choosing a running device because our device is running now. So I can select that, click OK, and we get our window up again. When that switches to the Android screen, we know that it's actually running again, the Android window. So we'll go back now to our emulator. It looks the same, but now if we click on the settings button, and now if we click on settings, we actually get that little message on the screen. The settings menu option got tapped, and notice how it disappeared automatically. And that's what the toast.long was, that indicated how long to the message should be displayed. And that's a variable amount of time that's stored within the toast functionality itself. So it's not, you can't sort of specify it to show for 5 seconds or something like that. Very simple example, but that's our first part of our application. We've now got it just showing something when that button is tapped. So I'm going to end this video here. In the next video, what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at our interface. So in other words, we're going to go back to our interface, and we're actually going to add a button here, and then we're going to start work. So if a button is pressed on the screen, we're going to get something to happen. So I'll see you in that next video.